Hi, this is Clinton from the Comedy Forecast podcast, found right here on the Mutual Audio Network. Found? Was it lost?
The following audio drama is rated G for general audience.
This episode originally released December 15th, 2022. It's the Bells and the Batfry Christmas Special for 2022.
You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming.
You mean the big fat man with the long white beard?
He's coming to town.
And I'm your host, John Bell, with a show that should be different and hopefully interesting. We're going to...
Mr. Bell, you're here!
Yes, Brad, it appears that I am actually, as you say, here.
Well, you haven't been here for the last two or three episodes.
That's because I've been away preparing for this special episode.
Preparing how? Preparing?
Brad, I have discovered that the two most popular things in podcasting are... true crime, and reality shows.
Neither of which your show is, unless the true crime is the show itself.
That's why I've spent the last few weeks sending microphones and transmitters to law enforcement agencies around the world.
You've been talking with cops everywhere?
Yes.
Nobody mentioned my...
No, nobody mentioned your name.
Well, of course. Why should they?
What we are now going to do on this episode is monitor all those officers on patrol and broadcast their activities live.
You mean like that TV show On Patrol?
Yes.
Which used to be PD Live.
Exactly. We're calling it Live on PD Patrol.
I will alert our lawyers.
You're my lawyer, Brad.
Consider me alerted. But wait a minute, how does that make this a Christmas special?
Because we'll be doing it live on Christmas Eve.
But this episode is being released before Christmas Eve. How can we do it live on Christmas Eve when it's before Christmas Eve?
That's where I come in.
And look who just came in.
And look who's going out.
Arnie, tell him about the invention I had you invent.
I call it the Christmas Eve Adventulator. Aren't you going to ask what it does?
I have found things go a lot smoother when nobody does that.
I'm glad you asked.
Nobody asked.
When I turn it on, it simply advances us to Christmas Eve.
Well, isn't that jolly?
So this episode will have had been live back in the future before now. Don't you have any questions?
No, that will just get you talking again.
Well, let's get started. Arnie, turn on the Christmas Eve Adventulator.
Radio. Okay, Mr. Bell, it's active and ready to go.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Live on PD Patrol Live. I'm John Bell, along with the Sheriff of February Berry, Brad Motworth.
I'm still the sheriff?
Yes, you are.
I don't even live there anymore.
And I'm sure the citizens have noticed the improvements.
And that's Arnie Cunchpart, our resident electronic advisor and super genius.
Making sure things run smoothly.
At least more smoothly than that last sentence.
We're monitoring the activities of law enforcement officers around the world, and the moment we hear something interesting going on, we'll cut directly to it.
Mr. Bell, there is police action in this small town, and the cops are on their way.
Excellent. Switch over live.
We've got a report of a bunch of kids standing in the snow and blocking traffic in this neighborhood. I'm sure they're around here somewhere. There they are. Let me see what I can do about this here. Kids, you gotta move along here. Move along.
What's going on here?
Look, what you're singing is really nice, but you're creating a disturbance here. What exactly is it you're trying to say?
Merry Christmas!
Okay, that's nice. You can say that, but do it out of the road and nice and quietly. Okay? Who's in charge here?
Charlie Brown! Charlie Brown!
Now, what did I just tell you, kids? All right, Brown, you're under arrest.
He's gonna get caught. Just you wait and see.
Why's everybody always picking on me?
Into the paddy wagon, all of you. Come on, you too. Yeah, you too. The dog. Come in. Yeah, you, someone get that dog. Call animal control. Hey, you there. I recognize you. Ain't you a teacher? You should be ashamed of yourself, big and fucking dancer.
And we're back in the studios of Live on Live PD Patrol Live, waiting for more law enforcement action.
Crime doesn't take a day off, even on Christmas Eve.
Or on Hanukkah.
Yes, or on Hanukkah.
Or Kwanzaa.
Right, don't forget Kwanzaa.
Or the winter solstice.
Are you done?
No, how about Boxing Day?
Boxing Day, I'm not familiar with that. What do you do on Boxing Day?
This.
Ooh. One, two.
But we got some police action. Let's go live. Let's go live.
I could have been a contender.
We've had a report of a man running up and down the street causing a disturbance downtown here. We're going to see if we can find him. Wait, that's probably him there.
Merry Christmas, movie
house! Sir, can we talk to you a minute?
Merry Christmas, you wonderful old Billy and Lone!
We are in foot pursuit. He's a lanky guy, a gray outfit, heading south.
Hey! Happy New Year to you! In jail!
Don't make us tase you, sir.
I gotta go home!
Don't make us tase you. Just settle down.
Settle down.
Let me get the cuffs on him.
Oh, come on, let me go!
There we go.
George, every time a handcuff clings, an angel gets his wings.
I'll put a sock in it, Clarence.
Okay, we're back in studio before that gets any uglier.
I see that we have a police officer getting a report of a disturbance at a Nakatomi Plaza in Los Angeles. Should we go there?
We can see what's going on.
Wait a minute, I don't see what a disturbance in a big building in Los Angeles has to do with Christmas.
Apparently there's a Christmas party going on inside.
Oh, big whoop, what a snooze. That doesn't have anything to do with Christmas. Let's go to something else.
Well, I see that in London, there's a B&E.
Bacon and eggs?
Breaking and entering.
Same thing.
How can breaking and entering and bacon and eggs be the same thing?
Well, duh. You gotta break the eggs before they enter your mouth.
But that's the stupidest
thing.
Well,
how do you eat bacon and eggs? I mean, you gotta...
Well, things have gotten uglier. Let's go now to London, England for some police action.
Wouldn't that be Bobby action?
Oh, you're the one that called us, Governor?
Yes, my name is Scrooge.
Scrooge McDuck?
Ebenezer Scrooge, and I have spirits.
Oh, been tippling a bit, eh?
I mean ghosts. I've already had one that said, I'm a ghost of Christmas past. And now I have one in there that says they're the ghost of Christmas present.
Well, I think it's nice it brought you a present, sir.
Not that kind of present. Oh, humbug. Just go in there and get rid of that ghost.
Well, lucky for you, sir, we have some blokes visiting from America who could do just that.
And who are you?
Ghostbusters.
We'll take care of everything.
It's in there. Go get it.
I am a ghost of Christmas present.
Okay, Ray. Just give me one eye outside.
You've never seen the like of me before. Stop that right now.
Oh, nice shooting, Tex. No!
It's in there.
Well, that wasn't such a chore now, was it?
Well then, that's done. Anything else we can do for you, sir?
Yes, I'll need you to come back in about an hour.
Okay, guys, apparently there is a pursuit in progress right now. Let's cut there directly and hear what's going on.
We are currently in pursuit of a steam locomotive and several cars in a residential area. Pull over! What can a train do that on track? Stop the train, please. Get out of the car here. Hello? Hello, is there anybody in charge here? All right, you. I need to talk to you.
Well, you coming?
Coming? Where?
Why, to the North Pole, of course. This is the Polar Express.
Right. I need to take a peek inside. Well, a lot of kids in here, but no parents or guardians or even adult supervision. All right, buddy. I think we got a kidnapping situation here. Oh, no, you don't. This train isn't moving a bit. And you kids, settle down, and if you're good, you can all have a treat. Would you like ice cream or...
Chocolate!
Hey, where'd all these dancing waiters come from? Is this the rest of your gang? That's it. I'm calling the FBI. But you know, this is a darn fine cup of hot chocolate.
Gee, you suppose that train was really going to the North Pole?
Only if you believe.
Believe what?
That it's going to the North Pole.
Guys.
You mean if I believe I'm going to the North Pole, I'll be going to the North Pole?
Well, I believe I wish you would believe so you would go to the North Pole.
Guys.
If believing is all it takes to make something happen, then... I'm a believer! That you're out of your mind! And I'm believing... But I am inclined. I'm so vexed. I'll have SpaceX choose you next to go to Mars and stay there.
Been there, done that.
Guys, I hate to interrupt this, whatever it is, but we really need to cut to the North Pole.
We're doing our standard patrol around the North Pole, mostly around the Claws compound. This over here is the reindeer training area, which is actually fairly exciting to see when they're out there training. Although when they are flying around, you do have to keep your eyes to the skies, if you know what I mean. And there seems to be something going on over there. Some sort of hubbub, but we better pull over and check this out.
Fireball, what's the matter?
Get away from me!
No, what's this nonsense here, Bucks? After all,
All right, everybody, what's going on here?
Hey,
Fireball Paws,
thanks now!
Stop calling me now!
All right, that's enough of that. That is enough of that.
All right, now, yearlings, back to practice.
All right, someone's being an adult.
From now on, gang, we won't let Rudolph join in any reindeer games, right?
Hold it right there, everybody. You.
Me?
You, the coach or whoever you are. You're under arrest.
Wait a minute. What for?
For bullying. Cheese and crackers, man. This is the North Pole. This is the happiest place on Earth.
Watch it there, fella.
You don't bully kids, you don't bully elves, and you don't bully reindeer.
Am I under arrest?
Yeah, we're putting you behind candy canes where you belong. As for everybody else, get along, or else...
Hey, you're okay.
Come along, you.
Oh, come on. I was just building character.
I am being told that things at Nakatomi Plaza are starting to get, a little weird.
Not a Christmas thing.
Well, I'm getting word there's actually a true Christmas story going on right now on Cleveland Street in Indiana. Let's check it out.
We got a report from the neighbors that there's a domestic disturbance going on at this house on Cleveland Street. We're coming up to the front door where we will, wait, do you hear that?
Wow, somebody's really cussing up a blue streak in there.
Hello, police department. Open up, please.
Well, that seems to be the problem here.
Sir, calm down. Ma'am, tell us what's going on here.
I don't know what happened. I was watering my plant and I... broke your lamp.
You were always jealous of this lamp.
Jealous of a plastic lamp?
Jealous. Jealous because I won.
Oh, yeah, like that's a major award or something?
It's ridiculous. That is the ugliest lamp I have ever seen in my entire life.
Not a finger.
Okay, you two, here's the way it's going to be. Ma'am, you find some glue so you can fix the lamp. You, sir, stop with the cussing or we're coming back here. And we're going to wash your mouth out with soap.
You two have a nice day. Goodbye. So would you really come back and wash his mouth out with soap?
Yeah. My personal preference is for Lux.
Yeah, but Palmolive has a nice piquant after-dinner flavor. Heady, but with just a touch of mellow smoothness.
Lifebuoy, on the other hand. Yeah.
It appears now that we have a traffic stop in progress. Let's go see what that's all about.
We were running our patrol and we noticed this vehicle in front of us. It has no taillights and no tag, so we're going to pull it over and check out what's going on here. Good evening, sir. Do you mind keeping your hands on the wheel?
I don't have a wheel. I have these reins.
What kind of vehicle is this, sir?
It's a sleigh, actually.
A Chevrolet sleigh?
More like a magical sleigh.
Could I see your license, registration, insurance, please?
That could be a little problematic there, officer.
What have you got in the back there, sir, in that giant sack?
Toys, my good man. Toys for the good little boys and girls in the world.
I see. Do you have a receipt for those toys?
No. My elves made these toys.
Elves?
In the elf workshop.
How much have you had to drink tonight, sir?
Well, if you count milk, several gallons so far.
Could you step out of the vehicle, please, sir?
Well, yes, certainly. I would be glad to, but I am on a tight schedule here.
Yeah, I'm thinking tight may be the operative term here, sir. I need you to perform a sobriety test for me.
Oh, I don't mind. I've taken dozens of them. Never failed one yet. Let me guess. You've got to ask, how many days in a week? 7. How many fingers do I see? 4.
Sir?
Who was the first president of the United States? George Washington.
If you could...
Who was vice president? Under John Quincy Adams, Daniel D. Tompkins. Did you know that?
No, but...
Now, you probably want me to touch my nose with my fingers.
No, I want you to put your hands behind that fuzzy red cap thing you got there.
Are you placing me under arrest?
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say may and will be held against you in a court of law.
This has gone on far enough.
Please cooperate, sir.
You passed the test with flying colors.
Sir, you passed the test with flying colors.
You're free to go now.
You're free to go now.
Move along.
Move along.
Oh. An officer, here's a gift for you.
Merry Christmas! Ho, ho, ho!
Oh, wow, let me open this up here. Cool, a really nice new flashlight. Let me turn it on and... Wow!
I really think we should check out this Nakatomi Plaza thing.
Oh, all right, let's go to the Nakatomi Plaza thing, see if it's interesting. He told you nothing was going on.
Okay, maybe you were right.
Yippee-ki-yay.
And that concludes our very first Christmas episode of Live on PD Patrol Live Cops, patrolling live with PD Patrol's thing. Merry Christmas, Beth.
Merry Christmas. What'd you bring out this time?
This is a catalog.
A what?
It's a catalog.
It's a cat?
Yes, a cat, that's a log, and you throw it on the fireplace.
Ooh.
No, you don't do that. This is what you use to order things that you want to give for gifts.
Okay. How do you get to Amazon?
No, you don't get to Amazon on it. You actually go through this and look at the pictures and decide what you want. This is a 1945 Sears catalog. Well, here's some baby dolls over here.
So what do they do? Do they eat? Do they poo?
No.
Do they talk?
No.
What do they do?
They just, you have to use your imagination with these.
What?
Your imagination. You have to pretend like they're their babies and you're taking care of them.
That's not fun.
Well, look at them. See how cute they are?
Make the picture bigger so I can look at them.
No, you can't make a picture bigger.
You can't? Come on, tap it.
This is paper. It's a photograph. You can't make it larger or smaller. That's all you get.
And she wasn't smiling.
Well, little baby dolls didn't smile a lot back then. They just kind of looked at you with an odd expression. Very much like you're doing to me right now.
Let's turn the page.
Okay. That's a xylophone.
A what?
It plays music when you hit it with those little hammers.
I want it.
You can't have that. No,
why
definitely.
Why not? I can beat it and...
That's exactly why I don't want you to have one. Now, here's something you might like.
What is it?
Here's a little doctor's kit. See, it has everything that a doctor needs when he makes a house call. Let me describe it to you. It says, little boys can be doctors, little girls can play nurse.
But I want to be a doctor.
Well, in 1945, you'd be up the creek. Okay, here's some more toys.
What are these? Airplanes and ships and guns and...
See, this was right after World War II, so there are a lot of toys with guns and military-type stuff.
Did they shoot?
Well, they click.
Is that all they do?
And this gun, if you blow on the hammer, it whistles, which is not really realistic.
A gun that whistles?
Yeah, stop or I'll toot.
You made a bad joke.
Here's some cars and trucks and trains and things like that. Toys back then were made out of wood.
Where are the batteries?
These didn't have batteries.
Are they remote controlled?
Yes, they are remote controlled. They have a string in the front and you pull it and that's how you control them.
That's terrible.
Well, things were a lot simpler back then.
I don't know how excited I get.
Okay, we have here's a toy telephone. This is what telephones looked like back then.
That's not going to fit my pocket. And what's that with the little holes in them?
That's the dial. You don't push it. It doesn't beep. It doesn't do anything by pushing it.
It doesn't do anything?
You spin it around when you made a call. And you let go and it goes...
That's too much work. We just have to push.
Yeah.
Put that in the cart.
This is a catalog. You can't just...
I want to look for the cart.
No, there is... Oh, and here's some sports things.
A bow and arrow?
Yeah, there's a bow and arrow and... Oh, my... They don't have suction cups. They're actually pointy.
Ooh, that sounds good.
No.
Why not?
It doesn't have suction cups. It has a little point on the end.
Now let's put that in the
Okay,
cart.
Tap it on the tap.
I'm going to put it in
okay,
the
so
cart.
It's, okay, that's good. It's in the cart now.
See, I'll put about 10 of them in there.
Now, here's something that I used to use back in the older days.
Yeah, you're ancient.
We used these to write documents.
You mean you didn't have your phone?
No.
No?
We had machines called typewriters that did that. And you see, each of these buttons, a key we called them, had a different letter on it.
Where's the screen?
It doesn't have a screen. You put paper in it, and the paper comes up in front, and you look at your paper while you're typing.
I would pound it.
Yes, you would.
Where's emojis? You know, like the little happy or the three-leaf clover or the little poopy thing.
Yeah, no, they didn't have those.
Boy, y'all didn't have much.
I know, it was stone knives.
All right, so let's go back through and create our cart.
You couldn't do that in 1945.
But why not?
You write down what you want. And you mail it to them.
You mean get a piece of paper and a pen? And,
yes.
And you put it in a little paper holdery thing?
You send it to them and you put in a check and they...
A check?
Yes. A check is... Oh, how do I describe checks?
You mean you can't put it on a credit card?
No, there were no credit cards
back then. You couldn't...
A check is a piece of paper where you write down how much you are giving them and the bank gives it to them.
Well, what if I wanted to give them $1?
Then you'd write a check for $1.
How about $100?
If you wrote a check for $100, you'd get $100.
Oh, boy.
Okay, wait a minute.
I like it.
I see where you're going with it.
And then I could write a check for $500 and $1,000.
No, no. You'd have to have that money in the bank first. They don't just give you the money.
They do. Well, you just said they give you the
money. Well, if you have the money, you get the money.
That's what you said.
All right. Go to the bank and write down how much you want. And see what happens. Okay? Well, we've run out of time, Beth, so...
All right. Should we let Homer talk?
All right, let's let Homer see what Homer has to say.
Deck the hawk with buddy holly.
Fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
In the knees and jump in jolly.
Fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
Okay, I'm putting Homer over here.
Oh.
And you say goodbye to everybody.
Goodbye, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Happy Hanukkah.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
And what year is it going to be?
It will be 2023 in a couple of weeks.
Wow.
Yeah. Ooh. And you'll be a whole year older.
Yeah, I will be.
Sadly, so will I.
That's true. You're going to be an old geezer.
Too late.
Bye.
Copyright 2022 by John Bell Creative, LLC.